Alright guys, so today we're going to be making a how-to video on making L.F.D. tube canes. And if you want to see how to use the tube cane, you got to stay tuned to LivinFree315 on YouTube, and we'll put those videos out more next week. So right now we're just going to show you how we're going to make them, so you can get the idea of how to build the actual cane. So the first general rule of building a L.F.D. tube cane is it has to be super clean. Because it's multiple layers, you know, we're going to be like 13 layers deep all together once you're with color and clear, color and clear. So you really got to make sure that the layers of clear especially are super clean. So the first thing you're going to want to do is we're going to clean all the glass super properly. Mm-hmm. All right, guys, so one big thing that's important is I'm only starting with this big of a piece of 26 by 4 mil. Not very big because it's going to end up huge. But I'm starting out with a 19 mil handle because the 19 mil seems big now, but by the time you got a piece of tubing that big around on the end of this, you're carrying a lot of weight. So you really want to make sure you start with a bigger size handle. I recommend 15 to 19 mil. You don't want to go much bigger than that because then your handle becomes obtrusive to like hold it and spin it. So a small piece of tubing here and a big piece of tubing here. You don't want to start with anything bigger than a 26 mil. This is going to be huge. So really start with like 19 or 12 to start with. All right, so now once you got all the stuff cleaned, you know, get your glasses, you got to start your prep work by getting it preheated, obviously. And you need a fan. So from here, we're going to go with different sound bites. Just laying the pattern on right here. It's going to be a rainbow pattern, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and then we're going to fill the rest in with aqua azul. Try to lay your lines on really close to each other, overlapping slightly so you get rid of the air bubble. Filling the whole rest of the back of the cane in with aqua azul. Just making a pretty standard tube cane right here. Once you've laid all the colors on, you need to melt it in really properly. Make sure that the glass is completely melted and smooth. Use a good, nice, easy flame on Crayolas if you're using them. If you boil them, they won't look nearly as good. Alright guys, so after you've melted the first layer in, you want to make sure it's fully melted in right now. You can see though that my pattern is the rainbow pattern right there. And I'm going to now clear coat this whole thing. The thicker the rod, the more prominent your layers are going to look. So, but also the way bigger your cane gets. We're going to be using 12 mil today because I've made a bunch of these. I recommend starting with about a 9 mil or 7 mil for your first one.
again, you want to make sure you overlap these. Don't let any color bleed through this layer of clear. If it does, you're going to have real problems with it later.
Alright guys, so what you want to do now is you see the edge of my the rainbow pattern here. You don't want to go any bigger than you have to on your first window. You want to make it as small as you can. And what I mean by window is this whole part's going to be filled with clear on this layer. The rest of it's going to be color. So I'm going to put my color line right directly over top of the red and right directly over top of the blue is what's going to happen now. Now, like I said, you want to be right over top of the colors. You want to make sure that they're, you know, just barely showing, because from an angle, you'll be able to see in there. You know, you can't really see them right now, but once it's all magnified, you will be able to. So next, you want to put your border color that's going on the outside of that. And we're using this Aqua Azul again. So you're going to now fill Aqua Azul all the way around the whole back side of this. And then we're going to fill this in with clear right now, just to show you the effect. So right now what we're going to do is fill this in with clear in between those two lines. All right, so in between the two colors that are glowing there, you got to really fill in the clear super clean the best you can. Because that's going to be your window that you're looking all the way through the next 10 layers of glass. Now, like I said, I'm going to fill the rest of this all the way in with Aqua Azul from there to there, and then we'll clear coat it again. Now you're just going to clear coat the whole thing again and melt it all in. Just going to start adding the next line over top of the lines like you did on the layer before. Make sure you're putting these right over top of the lines from below. You don't want much of them showing. It'll make its own V pattern eventually. Just because you're getting bigger every time, you don't really need to try to make your window that much bigger. In fact, if your window gets too big, your clear window, it'll make it so you can't get really any depth out of it when you wigwag it. So you want to try to make your windows as small as you can. Right here, you can see the actual V pattern it's starting to make in the end. Now another layer of color, and then another layer of clear.
with the four layers of color, starting to get pretty big. Definitely happy that I had that 19 mil handle. Last layer of color, and then two layers of clear coated over the top of it. I always do two layers of clear coat over the top because it has a tendency to bleed the colors through if not. Make sure this last couple layers of clear are really clear, clean. You want to make sure that this window is able to see all the way down to the bottom layers without too many air bubbles or anything like that. Keep it really clean. Alright, now I'm just going to fill in the whole background here all the way around it with Aqua Azul again. This is the fifth layer of color now, and we're going to clear coat it two more times after this. And by the time I'm done, it's going to be about a 90 mil, a little bit over 90 mil, and the hole inside is rather small, we'll say. There we go, all done. You can see how big they really get. The 19 mil handle now looks pretty small on this thing. And there you go. You want to add a big, huge moil to the end of this thing, a clear moil, so when you go to pull it, it makes it super nice and even. Be careful where you heat this. You only want to heat in the center. You want to be really diligent about getting just that middle really hot. If you don't soak the heat all the way through to the middle of this thing before you try to pull it, it will not pull correct. This one took me about a half hour to melt down with my Mirage Flame. I never had to kick up to my Delta Mag. Just use the Mirage the whole entire time, marver it, keep heating it and marvering it. Once you've got it hot and you know it's hot, you know, you're gonna be tired, sore, and beat. It's hours worth of labor, but when you finally know it'll move, give it a pull. Pull hard. And there you go. You have an L.F.D. cane. If you like this video and you try an LFD out, watch in a couple weeks or next week, we'll put out a video on how to use the LFD canes. You should expect a really small hole to be in these things. A lot of times I'm not even sure if there's going to be one by the time I get done, but they always end up with a little tiny bit of hole. This one's pretty small though. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you liked it, why don't you give us a follow on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter. We appreciate your views and hope you guys enjoyed the video. Have a great day.